Hello. Today we're trying to perform a 13-minute castle drop, playing as the Franks. I found this build order, watching one of KC Arion's build order analysis, where he was featuring a player called Professor 4K, who was playing a 1800-rated Ruby game a couple of years ago. This is definitely a very Eddie-style strategy, with one town center going forward. Now you will already start to see the spill over start to diverge as we'll be facing 3 villagers onto wood rather than the typical 4. It's also a good idea to take a quick swoop around the walls before starting to push your ibexes or deers, so that your enemy can't steal them. I don't want to idle on my sheep, so I take my boarhead a little bit prematurely. Next 4 villagers will face on to the berries. But our second villager will have first have to build a house. Another house on the last one. And now we want 10 villagers playing for town centers. Meanwhile, we start pushing some ibexes. And now we'll place 3 more villagers over to the berries. To push all of our ibexes, we can start exploring outside to find our opponent. There we go. On the last video, we should get 10 gold, so we'll be selling 100 stone for 91 gold, but we can go up faster. next 4 wielders we can send over to sorry, the next 2 wielders we send over to wield. It will also take 2 that are already here. As we'll be throwing a lot of food. I always like to scout with attack move, so that if my scout encounters his scout, I'm most likely to get the first hit. And now we'll prepare to build our market with 3 builders rather than 2, because we want to use our market as well. Okay, you can see our enemy scout there. Fire well, so we can try to snipe it, but it can't see what we're doing. As soon as the market goes up, we'll sell 100 stone. Then click up. There we go. Now let's start studying mining some stone. I'd like to sell 100 food for some gold so that I can research loom so that my villagers going forward aren't so vulnerable. I'll even add a few farms there. And I'll start sending 6 villagers forward. Into a castle. And I'll take 4 villagers of stone. So that I can make some more farms. The reason as to why I'm placing a palisade there is to so my builders will walk in a line and not walk like a big horde. And now we're up. I have to make sure to place our castle 2 tiles away from the wall and about 6 from the gate. Because as you can see, so it's at about the line of sight that we have as well. You should not be able to see this castle drop. As soon as our castle is up, we want to build a mining camp in his gold. There we go. Meanwhile at home we want to just start placing down as many farms as possible. So we can hit the Imperial edge faster. Meanwhile we can start to annoy him a little bit, so his space. See what he's up to. Can we snipe it? He's making a siege workshop head. I can easily counter that by making some throwing axemen if necessary. Though I don't think it will be. I think I can place on one more farm, and then I can go up to the Imperial Edge. First I'll get wheelbarrow. Actually, if it's done, not castle there. Nice gold. I don't know why these builders idle themselves like that. No, I choose to idle the town center. You can see I can almost go up. Up we go. This should be a really decent castle time. It's nice to snipe some villagers. I'll now actually make a second town center. Now I'll be flowing some food because I'm not using any. I'll just sell that so that I can make Treb jets faster. Nothing to worry about. Here comes some traps. Just in case he's going Imperial Edge, we can take out the Stunts Hunter. No Imperial Edge for him. Now I'll have to start nesting into knights. A bit annoying. Okay, I'm pushing the pants. This is gonna work. Making another vessel head. Yeah, it's very GG, as you can see. Can't do anything. Oh, it's gonna happen something. No! Oh, I lost the knight. That sucks. Yeah, this basically concludes the video. So I'm not sure what PowerPoint I can do now. Wait. That's a weird thing. Let's try to get the paladin upgrades. Oops. That's bad. I still have my starting scouts. What? GG would be nice now. Okay. There we go. Yeah, so that's a pretty good time, I think. Castle and Imperial Edge. This was an entertaining strategy you can consider using yourself. It might not always be so effective, as other players can always try to go for a really hard counterattack, like on your base. They sneak away from your castle, or they can go faster in Imperial Edge. They can also try some kind of castle push. That is kinda easy for you to counter. You can just make a siege workshop and some throwing axemen, and you can counter any pushback that he's gonna do in Castle Edge. So yeah, thanks for watching.